Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 60-second video class of DIP, we will study multi-resolution expansions in wavelets and multi-resolution processing and its implementation in MATLAB. See, we have already learned image pyramids, subband coding and hard wavelet transform in our previous few video classes, and hence we know the foundation of wavelets and multi-resolution processing. So now we move forward towards understanding of multi-resolution expansions. Starting with the name, what is the meaning of multi-resolution? Multi-resolution means more than one resolution, and expansion means breaking down or expanding, right? So in simple terms, multi-resolution expansions means breaking down or decomposing a signal or data or image, in case of image processing, into different scales or resolutions. That means we are doing expansion of a given image into different resolutions. Okay, so let us start. Multi-resolution expansions in wavelets refer to a mathematical framework for decomposing signals or data into different scales or resolutions. This concept is fundamental in wavelet analysis and multi-resolution processing. See, we know that wavelets are mathematical functions that can be used to analyze signals in both the time and frequency domain simultaneously. But unlike traditional Fourier analysis, which uses fixed sinusoidal basis functions, wavelets are flexible and adaptive, allowing for localized analysis of signals at different scales. Multi-resolution analysis provides a systematic way of decomposing signals into different levels of detail or resolutions. The idea is to represent a signal using a set of basis functions known as wavelet functions that capture different frequency components and time localized features. The multi-resolution expansion is typically obtained by applying a series of filtering and downsampling operations to the signal. At each level or resolution, the signal is decomposed into two components: an approximation component that represents the coarse scale information or low frequency details, and a detail component that represents the high frequency or fine scale details. And this process is repeated iteratively, resulting in a hierarchical representation of the signal with multiple levels of approximation and detail coefficients. The approximation coefficients capture the overall trends or low frequency components of the signal, which is known as scaling function, while the detail coefficients highlight the localized variations or high frequency components, which is known as wavelet function. Multi-resolution processing refers to the manipulation and analysis of signals or data in the multi-resolution domain. Once a signal has been decomposed into its multi-resolution representation, various operations can be performed, such as denoising, compression, feature extraction, and signal reconstruction. By utilizing the different levels of detail and approximation coefficients, multi-resolution processing allows for a more efficient representation and analysis of signals, particularly those with non-stationary or time-varying characteristics. Wavelet-based methods have found applications in various fields, including signal processing, image and video compression, data analysis, and pattern recognition. We know that wavelet uses two types of functions, scaling function and wavelet function. The scaling function is used to create a series of approximations of a function or image, each differing by a factor of 2 in resolution, as we already understood in the previous video classes. It is given by this equation. While the complementary functions of scaling functions, called the wavelet function, are used to encode the differences between adjacent approximations, giving high pass details, and is given by this equation. The DWT or discrete wavelet transform uses these wavelet functions together with a single scaling function to represent a function or image as a linear combination of wavelets and scaling function. For example, the wavelet series expansion is given by this equation, which is a combination of about two equations. Let us first understand the scaling functions. In this equation of scaling function, translation k determines the position of phi jk of x along the x-axis, and scale j determines its shape, that is its width and amplitude. For this unit height, unit width, hard scaling function, when the scale is 1, that is when j is equal to 1 in this equation, the scaling functions are half as wide as when the scale is 0 in this equation. See, in this equation, if we keep j is equal to 1, then it is 2 raised to 1 by 2 into phi, and 2 raised to 1 by 2 is nothing but root 2. Okay, hence when scale is equal to 1 or j is equal to 1, the scaling functions are half, or you can say root 2 of phi. But when the scale is 0 or j is equal to 0, it is 2 raised to 0 by 2, that is 2 raised to 0. Anything raised to 0 is 1, right? So it is full phi of x. Okay, so if we denote the scaling function subspace by vj, then two V1 scaling functions, phi of 1, 0 and phi of 1, 1, are located in the interval 0 to 1. While when j is equal to 0, that is for V0, scaling function phi of 0,0 occupies the same interval 0 to 1. But for such complex scaling space, V0 is so coarse or so unrefined that it cannot be used for such complex representation, and higher resolution scaling functions like V1 are required. So note here that V0 is coarse or unrefined as compared to V1, that is V1 is sharper than V0, V2 is sharper than V1, and so on. So we see that V0 is a subset of V1, V1 is a subset of V2, and so on. This means that as we go towards higher scales or larger J, the function becomes sharper. Okay, and these are the requirements of multi-resolution analysis. Let us now understand wavelet functions. So as there is a scaling function for the approximations or low pass, similarly there is wavelet function for the differences or high pass. Also the equation for the wavelet function is similar to the equation for the scaling function. Just in place of phi, we have psi. Now as we denote the scaling function subspace by V, similarly we denote the wavelet function subspace by W. And now the scaling and wavelet function subspaces are related by Vj plus 1 is equal to Vj union of Wj. And this symbol denotes the union of function spaces just like union of sets. So here in this fourth slide, we understood that there is a single scaling function and more than one wavelet functions. Right. So now see this figure here. V0 is the scaling function. V1 is the union of V0 and W0. Similarly, V2 is the union of V1 and W1. But V1 is V0 union of W0. Right. So we will keep the value of V1 of this equation over here. So V2 is equal to V0 union of W0 union of W1. Okay. So see in the equation of V2, there is one scaling function V0 and more than one wavelet functions W0 and W1. So in this way, we can perform multi-resolution expansions. I hope it is clear. Let us implement multi-resolution in MATLAB. This program shows multi-resolution pyramid of an image. We are reading an image Maulik.png and going on reducing its resolution using impyramid. So in that way we obtain I1, I2 and I3. Let us run the program and see the output. So you can see that we are obtaining an image pyramid of decreasing resolution. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.